This trunk is messed up, so calm down.
Hello, how's everybody doing? Today should be a good day. We should be doing a lot. I'm pretty sure you already know what we're doing from the title of the video. But before we do that, we gotta pick up Lit User, AKA Johan. Go to Advance, pick up some stuff, Walmart, and... Oh yeah, my tire's kinda low. Went to good old Advance and got this stuff. Now it's time to go pick somebody up.
Yo, what's good?
Yo, how you doing?
Johan shop. Yuck.
Yo, what's good?
Yo, so as you can see in the title of the video, we're doing a valve cover. Yes, good, right?
Yes, sir.
So I'm guessing we gotta take this vacuum intake line, this, a bunch of little bolts. I don't know if they're 10. Got the needle nose. We got Johan helping, finally working on my set together.
Yo, quick tip for these hoses is just to break them, cut them. You won't ever need it again. I'm kidding.
Oh, okay, I think like, what should we do?
Should we take the intake off to have more room?
Hell yeah. After a lot of messing around, we put my phone onto Johan's cool box, that's for sale. If you want it, hit him up. This is Instagram. Time lapse. I'll turn the lights low while you make yourself comfortable, babe. Intake's out. Strut tower, Eiffel Tower thing is out. Now Johan loosened all the bolts. What do we do now, Johan? We gotta get the gloves. Yeah, just in case that coronavirus.
This is a corona-free shop.
There you go.
I mean, we have to draw the valve cover, right?
Oh yeah, true.
So like, that's one hole. Yeah. Move it up.
Mhm.
That's that hole.
Many holes later. Look at that tuck job. Here's your gun. You bought it for that.
Oh, sweet, thanks.
We're deleting this. We don't need it. See ya. Oh, I hope I don't need it. Then one more, this bracket. I don't know, I think that's for cruise control, which, but let's take this guy out.
Hope that don't drop the bolt.
Oh, look at that.
So much. Hold up, say that again.
Oh, sorry. Got the bracket out, looking real fresh.
This is about to be a fucking video all over that fucking bracket.
All we had to do was delete the bracket, right?
All right, guys, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. We'll catch you on the next vlog. I'm cold-hearted and broke. I cold-started and the classic. I stopped recording.
Oh, it's hot. We should open it so it can cool down.
That works. Hell yeah, dude. We did a radiator fan delete.
Oh, yeah, looking fresh.
We don't need radiator fans in this state. Yeah.
That's.
Yeah. You'll be all right, bro. Just cover it up.
Yeah.
All right, bet. Let's fucking do this. What's next? Loosen this one up. I don't think I did. Hit the snap. You fucking missed it.
You got it.
Oh, I did.
Dude, you got it all.
The one for the coil packs?
Oh, those kind of loose, aren't they? That's off. That guy. This valve cover's had a shit. Last guy. We
go.
Ready, yo.
Let's
we...
go. Sorry, okay. If you can't hear us over the little peep.
No, you're good, bro. You don't got to try it now.
Sorry, bro.
You got it. Johan to find a better card, boy.
Picasso.
Uh-huh.
He has one, two. Holy fuck.
What happened?
We got a lot of fucking bolts on this thing. I don't know what I drew, dude.
A lot of dots.
It looks like one of those things, you know, like the blind people would have to put their hands to read it.
Yes, this is a Miata.
So, I guess we're gonna start removing the coil pack.
Yeah, let's do the coil packs.
But. Looking real purdy. There you go. We back from a little break. We just
What's good? We ate some chicken nuggets.
They're amazing. Uh-huh. What's next? What should we do?
Let's just finish checking up all the bolts and put them in that box over there.
Yeah.
You get that zoom in?
Mm-hmm.
All right, and then we get cracking from there.
So we're pretty sure we got all the bolts off. Look at that. Go ahead and do a little research real quick to make What?
Like, I'm a Miata expert, but like, don't fucking, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we don't want to mess it. We're trying to pry it off and it's not really moving. Whoa. So Johan taking out this giant ass bolt. That's a 19. So after this, hopefully it should just pry out. If not, the cat's on fire.
It's fine, bro.
Yeah, you gotta keep playing with it, right?
For sure.
But look, when you lift this up, look at this. So maybe we have to remove that. It's gonna be too bad though, right? We got this.
We got this. We're not sure. But
yeah.
We got this.
It could be like that. We got the VVTi solenoid off. So all you have to do is basically fuck with it a bunch of times till it starts to pop out. With the gasket, we're gonna reuse it.
We'll spray something on it, don't worry, guys.
Oh, we got our TV, right? So,
yeah.
We'll put a little something. Now you should be able to lift it up.
Yes.
Oh!
Yo, so we got it off. All it was just the VVT actuator just wouldn't let us lift it at an angle. Had to be straight up.
It was this motherfucker right here.
Hey, you got it out, right?
Hey, if you stop making so much fucking noise. Alright, so either way. Alright. We're gonna go ahead and paint this shit, clean it up, paint it, we'll show you how we do that. We're expert at that shit. You know, we know what the fuck to do. I just gotta watch Chris Fix do it first. We'll be right back.
What's happening? What's going on?
Yo, what's good? We're prepping this valve cover.
Yeah.
I don't know shit, so don't go to the fucking comments and fucking come for me, alright? We're almost done here prepping it. We're just cleaning up.
There you go. It's very ugly here. Look at that.
Yeah.
Ew. Good thing we got good old brake cleaner, right?
Get some big greaser on there.
Picking up the camera. It's been like an hour. Johan heated up the bolts. They're ready to be painted. And the valve cover, that was so annoying. Johan did like most of it. He was cleaning the shit out of it. He was using the brush, brake cleaner, that special degreaser. He masked it for me. Normally people use foil, but
yeah.
Tape is fine, right?
Okay, what's the worst what can happen?
Exactly. Basically, it's ready to paint. Well, we're gonna heat it up or?
Yeah, make it a little warm. It's real cool.
I love that guy. So we got that Walmart special primer, white, cheap rattle can, and some cool red. Dude, how do we have the setup here? What do we have?
We got ventilation, intake at the same time, new way to do it. We got heat just to bake it all up. This is just gonna make sure everything, the paint adheres. And we got our spray guns, three of them.
Ooh.
Three stage paint job right here. We're just learning as we go.
Got two bins, two. Yeah, it takes kind of a few in here. I think there's a little oil. But...
yeah, there was. I wiped it off. It burns the wood.
Oh my goodness.
So like, it's fucking hot.
Dude, I can smell the wood burning. I wonder if we can make a fire out of this.
Yeah. Oh.
Dude, it's smoking.
Yeah, welcome to CEOs of starting a fire. Next to a gas tank.
That's how safe we are. Primer up.
Yeah, let's lay the first coat on there.
Oh, I can get my primer ready.
Right.
That test that I
hear. Yeah. Get the spray pattern down. Make sure you know the spray pattern. That's too close.
Too close.
That was way too close. Don't ever do that again.
I won't try about that.
All right. Okay. Yeah, no, you're good, dude. Something like that, yeah.
Something like that?
Yeah. You want to put the first layer on pretty light.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
Should have just kept going.
That's a little bit lighter than that.
That okay?
That's normal. That's.
Dude.
Why is it doing that? Okay, let me see it. We'll be right back after these short messages.
Dude, look so good. You're way better than me. I'm glad you're doing it.
This has a little fog.
Yeah, I ruined it. It's alright. We just let it sit. We can like.
You don't have sandpaper, huh?
Cause now we just put more primer over it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe like a minute.
5 minutes, I mean.
Oh, 5 minutes, yeah.
Money shot.
We're getting there.
But we just don't know what the fuck we're doing before, you know what I mean? Till we get there.
Yeah. But hey, at least we're using actual primer, not just straight rattle candidate. Hey, it actually doesn't look bad in video. In real life, though?
Oh, dude, in real life, this is a fucking masterpiece. She's looking fucking good, dude. She's looking scrumptious.
Yeah, so good.
Don't tell him!
To stand like 10 feet away from it, money.
It's a 10 by 10. 10 feet away, 10 miles an hour. Can't fucking tell the difference between this and a powder coat job. Swear to fucking God, this is beautiful.
Yeah.
You get a couple eggshells and the fucking mix and you fucking try and give up halfway through, but you never fucking look to the end, all right? What is that?
No, what the fuck?
Can I burn it? Blow on it.
Hey, we did.
Let's go. Yeah, I mean, just be careful, Kevin.
I'll be extra careful. Dude,
I'm impatient.
We're ready for paint.
We're ready for paint.
We're ready for paint.
Let me heat it up. You see any dimples?
No dimples.
No dimples. Be right back with some YouTube magic. We're back. Go ahead and just take a look at the bottom of that. You see all those little dimples?
Oh, yep.
She's fucking ready. Okay, you want to do a light and then little bit thicker, and you're gonna want to go in one motion, and you're gonna want to pass over that again in another motion.
Bet.
Just went side to side. We're doing the ups and up and down now. This is how to avoid tiger striping.
Bet.
Don't want that shit.
Not here.
I'm kidding. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. This is literally a mirror. This is literally how they make mirrors. Can we get a comparison?
Yeah, it's pretty
odd. It's not the same color.
We're ready for some red?
Maybe.
Maybe.
What do you think? Take a look around.
You think we're ready? We're ready. It's kind of good, right?
It's looking good, honestly.
You want to do one more cut, or is this fine?
Is this B-hole approved? Like, if you were B-Hall, would you be like, yo, this is ready?
I think B-Hall would be very proud of us.
You think so?
I know so.
B-Hall, this one's for you. We just hydro-coned it.
Yeah.
This is natural. We haven't even painted this yet. Kevin, you think it's ready for some red?
I think it's ready. Oh! I hope it looks like that.
I really hope we don't get overspray on that thing.
Giving it the dimple.
I see some already. See some of them forming?
Yeah.
We gotta figure out the spray pattern. Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Very watery.
I'm liking that. I'm liking that.
Yo, it smells like strawberry. Is it just me?
Right, it does, yeah.
Ooh. Okay. Okay. I like it. It's slack, right?
This shit's slapping, dude.
Dry, can I try to give it a shot so I can look like I did something? So, I forgot the VVTi solenoid, so I want to do this black, I want to do this like the dark red. Johan made this beautiful cover. I did this one very ugly, but that's the job. Let's get the paint real quick.
Oh, what's good?
Hardware's painted, this rail, whatever that thing is, painted by VVTi solenoid painted. Now this is the part we kind of messed up on. We should have taken the valve cover off first. I mean,
hey, we don't mess up around here, brother.
You know what? Sorry, I'm gonna. Okay. All right, so now after you paint it, now you change your gasket. The proper way. Make sure you do not touch the paint and take that gasket off carefully.
It'll only fucking make your gasket go on perfect, all
right? Exactly. It makes you more careful, right?
That's all it is, dude. Exactly. And right here, we're in the business of making shit work.
Exactly. All
right? So grab your fattest set of pliers.
Mm.
Pull it a little bit. Mm. And then just peel your bag, brothers.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Ooh. Still one piece. Sometimes I would reuse it, but
you know,
like
it's just,
it.
it's leaking a little bit. You can tell from the parts where it's leaking from. It's leaking because it's leaking.
Yeah.
And this is why you don't want to change it before. You see this, we got some overspray on the gas. This is the sequence. So now we're going to pick this up.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to walk it over here.
We can put it right on.
Send her on.
There you go. We don't need a gasket.
I don't need a gasket.
What's the point of a gasket? Metal on metal.
Just weld it together, dude. Need a clean working area.
Oh my goodness.
All right, brother. Did you grab the new one?
Where that?
Clean working.
I should have paid attention. Always keep your RTV on your door. I grabbed a couple more stuff. I painted it. I painted the engine hook. Some bolts. We're ready.
Yo, what's good?
We back.
The camera died. We're not recording on a phone. Sony A7500. Camera died. He charged it up. Took a water break.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna go ahead and do that gasket for you guys now. Rule number one, grab some RTV. Handle with care. So, that better fucking open it.
Nice.
I'm so sorry.
I think it's dry, so we get.
I'm so sorry.
No, I think it's funny. Pro tip.
Pro tip, use the tip. Now you got a nice bead laying down.
Dude, that is so satisfying.
That's nice, that's nice.
It's like putting a straw in a Capri Sun.
Literally.
All right. I like how you have I can say head gasket. The valve cover gasket, you know, like on the jacks. It's a jack pull. As long as it works,
right? It's for presentation, dude. It's for presentation, that's it.
Ooh. You guys are doing this. Here's the part number.
This baby upside down.
Ooh.
Is it dry? Touch right here.
We're good. Wait, can we go like?
Yeah, the letters look mid.
Don't get a close up on the letters. All right, ready?
Yes, sir.
Bloop. Look at the beautiful masking job.
All right. Now you got an RTV, I think.
Yes, sir. Your RTV at the '90s. skimming. He's skimming. That's a perfect explanation, you know what I mean?
There you go. Yeah.
Just skimming. I mean, you always skim it. If you don't do this, they're gonna most likely leak. Yeah, and no. You're a piece of shit because you gotta do it all over again.
Did this count as a 90 or? Is that old RTV?
Yeah.
Somebody must have done it.
We don't expose us, Kevin. We cleaned all the old RTV off.
And now she's ready to go on.
I did the inch that too. Boom. Solenoid.
You took it apart. I don't know where you took it apart, but you took it apart. I know that.
Yeah. It's gonna be hand tight right now. And that's why we did that, because now we know basically where the bolt should go. Oh my goodness,
the rail.
That rail for air.
For
VVTI, solid oil, I forget. Oh, we also got most of the hardware back on.
All the little bolts, they look so cool.
Dude, what? We need the fresh side. Dude, that looks amazing. It looks like brand new on camera.
It's definitely better.
Not gonna make the radiator look terrible. That's right, we're getting a new one soon. Wow.
It's so complicated.
It's good. What are you trying to do here?
I'm trying to find a socket that's like 8.5, 8.
Maybe like a standard one?
Yeah, that weird size one.
I don't know.
That American.
Yo, you're good, dude. Here.
I'm about to do the flathead, dude.
Where's my 8? It was right here.
We're about to give her a crank. Well,
here's how the red came out. It's not bad.
Dude, I love it. You like it?
I like it. I like it a lot. It turned out a lot better.
Right?
Some people that didn't know what the fuck we were doing. But we just went through with it. Right now, we're just gonna look for some leaks because some complications happened. Mainly in this area. Oops. Go ahead, turn it on now. Alright guys, that's gonna be it for this episode. Like, comment, subscribe.
Here's everything that got deleted. All these brackets, couple bolts, and a few like clips, hangers. And I can save these for something else if I ever need them. Couple days later.
That looks so good. And now all we need to do the intake manifold because it looks very janky. It needed some love.
But shout out to Johan. Here's his Instagram lit user. He helped the crap out of me. Like, he polished this, made it look beautiful. He helped me through most of it. He was very patient. Now Martha's engine bay is looking real pretty. I couldn't be any happier with how it turned out. And we also did this. This used to be rusty and ugly. Johan pointed out to do this. I'm glad we went for it because it looks so much better. Oh yeah, he filled up my brakes too because I was very low. I even had a brake light on. I thought it was because of my handbrake. Here's a little edit.
Inspired by Jimmy O. Jimmy O's has a 300ZX with a SR on it. They call it the SRZ. It's beautiful. So that's why I wanted to do it like that red, that metallic red. Here's a little picture. We also watched some Chris Fix videos because who doesn't watch him?
And then Johan helped the crap out of me do all of this.
Without him, I would not have been here, honestly. But that'll be it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Press that like and subscribe. You're awesome.